So day 44, actually, I weighed in at 191.1 today. And for breakfast, we're just having the standard oatmeal with blueberries, basically a half cup. So 30 calories there, roughly 100, 120 calories in banana, and then the 300 calories in oatmeal. And then on the side today, I think I'm gonna try to actually mix a scoop of this with a scoop of this and just see how it tastes, because this is the Nutter Butter, and this is just straight chocolate. So this is 30 for 160, and then this is 26. So it'll be around extra 56 grams of protein. So we'll see how that tastes, and if I don't really mess with it, then I'll probably get through that entire tin of the chocolate before the Nutter Butter. And I plan on getting a blender, I just haven't decided on which one yet. And then I might just start making my breakfast in the actual blender. All right guys, so it's about 2 hours before our lift, and we're going to do our little protein experiment. So we'll see how this actually goes. I'm not too sure how I feel about this. I don't know what to expect, and I hope it's not really, really good, to be honest, because then I'm gonna go through this way, way faster than I'd like to. But we got one scoop, a little less than one scoop, but it's fine. We got one scoop right here. Boom, boom, boom. We got one scoop right here. And honestly, the chunks of the Nutter Butter is kind of weird, bro. I don't like chunks. Interesting. We'll call it an interesting marketing decision, because they're definitely in there. It's just a little weird. All right, so we got two scoops. So this is roughly nearly 60 grams of protein. Throw that there. And then I'm just gonna make this. I'm literally just gonna throw that much water in there. And then I'm just gonna stir this up. Figured I'd show you guys this little process right here as well. We got this little special spoon right here that's gonna be, it has that little opening in the middle, so it'll help get a little bit extra turnover, a little extra current in there because of the air holes. Oh, you see that? Look, chunks of Nutter Butter in this, dude. I don't know how I feel about it. Like, if I'm drinking a drink, I don't want it to be chunky. I'm not drinking, like, orange juice with a pulp. I never would. Like, I have, but I wouldn't. Let's see. Yeah. You know what? Taste test. We'll do the Nutter Butter chunk. Standalone Nutter Butter. You know what this is gonna taste like? Hot chocolate. That's what this is gonna taste like. That's what I get from it. So I'm gonna keep stirring it. And you know what? Screw it. We'll just send it right now. All right. I have a feeling this is gonna taste like hot chocolate. Hold on now. Hold on now. That was kind of fire. I'm not gonna lie. No cap, that's actually kind of fire. It literally tastes like hot chocolate without like being hot. So I'm gonna finish this all, and then I'll catch you guys at the gym. Alright, so the one dude we know was running on the treadmill when we got in here, so about that quiet, but there's another dude who is pretty thick. We'll call him thick, not overweight, we'll call him thick. He was hitting something with the dumbbells, and then basically as soon as I pulled out my camera, he dipped. But we hit 200 for 8. Well, first we hit 185 for 10, 200 for 8, and then after the 200 for 8, we did the 115. So we bumped up 10 pounds on the single arm press, but I have both arms up, stabilization, and make sure I don't like hit it weird or like put unnecessary stress on like one side. So it's just pretty, I'm able to keep my base and just still get those reps in. And then we did that for 115 for 6, and then we tried 125, bumped up, and eventually, dude, I'll work up to 200 with one arm for reps. We're doing it. This is what we're doing. But I'm feeling pretty good, man. Coming into today, my anxiety, like just general anxiety, like whenever I drink protein powder, it just makes me feel kind of like shit, I'm not gonna lie. So now we got 200 for 8 and then 185 for 10. 200 for 8. Definitely should not lift my feet up, because now you need to leg drive at least a little bit. 185 for 10 now. Drop your shoulders back. Shoulders above the hand. Don't do that. So that was 10. I'm thinking about adding in just a front raise, but I don't know. Do I really need to add it in? I'm not sure.
We're definitely gonna work the rear sides out today.
All right, so we're gonna try this out. We're gonna try to do 170 for 10 for the first time. Big jump, not really, because we did 8 reps last time. So we're doing 170 for 10, then we're gonna do 185 for 8, hopefully. I mean, we'll see. We're just gonna go from there 200 for 6, and then we'll do the same thing with the chest press, where we're really only using the one arm at a lower weight, like 115 or 105, but it's just the one arm working.
So we'll see how that's going. So 170 for 10.
Hey, that flew. It's so weird, man. It has to be muscle memory. You know, I never really did shoulder press specifically. Not really looking good for convincing people I'm natty. Defending my natty status when we keep jumping up like this. It would be really cool though if like one of the big guys like Greg or Derek were like, natty or not, we're having the wall. Gorilla Rob, natty or not. All right, 185, 4, 8. Get my base now. Hey, we did it though. Woo! Now we got 200 for 6. Also, yesterday's back day, my entire back, like through and through, top to bottom, was pretty sore. This is so funny though. 200 for 8. Day 44 in the first, well, the second week is when we got in here. The second week, I wasn't even able to do 95, and now we're repping 200. Oh, come on. All right, you guys have earned the right for you guys to not call me daddy. Getting leaner day by day, bro. 200 for 6. Now we're gonna move on to the single reps. Just one arm for, well, one arm for one, and then drop back down to probably like 185 for 8, and then 170 for 10. I don't know if this is a bad idea, but I'm feeling pretty confident now that we hit those 3 sets. So we're gonna shoot for 115 for 1 with one arm. So you guys are gonna see both arms moving, but only one arm is gonna be working each time we do it. So right arm. Left arm. Right. Right. I'm a freak. I'm an ape. I'm a gorilla. We're gonna start doing this. Next 2 drop sets, we're doing 185 for 8, and then 170 for 10. Now we got 170 for 10. All right, last set, 170 for 10.
I got 2 balls, 1 for the blood, 1 for the low. I got 2 balls.
All right, now we got to get hit. Bicep, tricep, lateral belt, you're done.
I will say also, my arms are definitely growing, so. I think it's because of the circuit. I think the circuit's really, really hitting the biceps the way they're responding.
Also, we're getting leaner too at the same time, so probably mix them both.
One more curl for this arm. Boom.
I think I'm also gonna do that other variation where we're delts, where we're literally just like right here with it. We're gonna hit side delts. Biceps are tired today, but it's cool.
I think I'm just gonna throw in the rear delts in here as well. Now we're gonna curl, and that's one pull.
Circuit of these accessories. I'll add on the triceps. We'll do that at the end.
Might as well throw the triceps on top of there as well. See the arm development. Arms are growing, that's for sure. A little pumped up right now because obviously we just hit those sets. So 15 and 100. My core is very sore today, so it's a lot harder to do these. You stop at 10. I don't know, guys, am I making progress? Hard to tell when you're so high in body fat, but
I'd say we're on the way. Shoulder veins going through.
This is brutal. And again, 30s were brutal for a minute. And then eventually I graduated from 30s. And eventually we'll be doing this for 40s and so on and so forth. I don't really know what my limit is on these because I never really went past 20 all my life. Because like for wrestling, it doesn't matter how much you can curl. Compound lifts matter. Like compound lifts matter because you're lifting somebody. You're going to be lifting somebody with doubles and 0.5 feet to back, 5-point moves, just general takedowns. But you're never gonna be trying to curl somebody. That's why I never really cared about it. I only really ever cared about my bench squat, and then I like to do Zercher pull or Zercher squats, where you go down, get the bar under, and squat like that. I used to do sets of 225 with that as well. Because that was actually like functional towards wrestling, because you get a takedown, you're gonna have to pick the person up. So those were really good if you wrestle instead of just doing Zerchers. Also, it'll fuel your ego when your friends aren't able to go heavier because they're in pain, like they can't bounce the barbell because it hurts too much. Made me feel like a man. That's a man lift for sure. And when I'm doing those raises, all I'm really thinking about, honestly, is making sure I don't start dipping my elbows. Just like through the entire cut, you guys have been able to see how bad I am with dipping my elbows. It takes away from actual raise.
Yeah, you would.
The ninth rep is usually sketchy, perfect.
And honestly, dude,
I think after I get super lean, man, I try to get into powerlifting and strongman lifts, like with the stones and the hustle foe thing, where it's like that coffin, because my older brother does all that kind of stuff and it looks fun. I just like to pick stuff up, put stuff down.
Now we got rear delts.
Also, I don't do anything for my forearms. My forearms just kind of grow from all weightlifting. Now we got 35 for those 10 standing. I'm just glad we're gaining, dude. Even though we're cutting weight, see, it's possible to recomp natty. It's just not gonna be like an insane like 10, 15 pounds plus of muscle on top. I mean, I really have no idea how to calculate how much mass the like lean tissue we're gaining. I'm just happy to be here. I'm happy to be gaining.
Happy to see the progress.
Triceps now. These are so much harder because of how sore my core is. Triceps feels at 6. Well, in my mind. Here we go.
One more set of the circuit left.
Third and final set. Oh, my hand calluses are digging into these grips.
And after this whole circuit we're gonna do,
bruh, will be, yeah, dude, that shit looks bustin', dude.
Arms are dead.
definitely getting fucked up. But we got one more chest day, so we're just gonna push them through. I don't care. We got one more chest day this week, so we're straight. It's great to hit these reps, all three exercises, and we'll dip it until the next day.
Depending on how fast we progress with these
35s, we might bump up to 40s. All right, so we got 5.
Lost control there. My biceps to a muscle. Didn't want to execute that lift. So we got to do 2 on this arm, 1 on this arm. Since we just fell on this arm, we're gonna hit this one. That's it right there. One big magma jam. Did a little bit of assisting because I felt some pretty good strain down here. Don't know if it was just like the muscle stretching, me overextending, what it was, but I really do not want to tear my biceps. So little precautionary assistance there because I don't want to do 5 extra reps on this arm and stop at 5 on this arm. And our next cheat day is gonna be Christmas.
Woo!
Christmas, I might figure out because by the time Christmas rolls around, like 20 days, we should be considerably leaner. Arm bang coming through, irrelevant for this exercise. All right, boys. Don't act on that.
It wasn't talking to you.
Rhetorical.
No, it wasn't rhetorical.
Just don't think about it, alright? My lower back is so sore. It's hard to do this. Let me bump you guys down so you can see the shot.
God, I'm such an idiot.
Figured out how we can work our lower back. Biceps. Dude, we're definitely getting there.
Come on, bro. Look at me. I'm getting leaner.
Getting leaner for sure. Alright, 7 more. Now we gotta run.
The day was a lot slower, guys. Day 44.
I think after we hit 1.5, we dropped down to like 0.45, about a minute. 2 is definitely a minute, and I think a minute 30. And then at 2.5, I actually had to go to the bathroom. That was a 2-minute break for me to get to the bathroom, go to the bathroom, and get back. Started running as soon as I got back, and then it was a minute 30 each. Because my shins are starting to wear down. So if I get shin splints, at this point, probably won't surprise you, but we're gonna run through them, even if I get them. I did that my senior year wrestling season. Guys, join your wrestling team. You wanna know how this is possible natural? Learn how to suffer. Get good at it. And you don't have to do this by any means, but this is just how I know how to do it. But you can see, shirt check, we did put in our work. And now we're gonna go back. I'll show you the physique and we're gonna eat. Day 44, and you guys can see the shirt is soaked all the way through. And you might be asking yourself, like, Rob, why don't you stop when your body starts to hurt? And the reason is, because I don't stop when it starts to get tough. You're not gonna get tougher when you stop every time it starts to get tough. It's called progressive overload. When it gets tough, that's how you know you're working hard. Pretty much I just owe to myself to keep going when the going gets tough. But that's how you build up strength, toughness, grit, that mindset. But we're probably getting leaner. I can't really see the camera all too well right now. I think we're definitely getting leaner. Tricep action right there. Side view of the bicep. This light makes my biceps look so much worse. I don't know what it is. I think it's just because I have such high body fat right now. But yeah, moral of the story is there's a difference between being hurt, injured. You're not gonna progressively overload. You don't keep going when the going gets tough. That's just how I am. You're gonna be like, Rob, it's unnecessary, all that junk. To me, it's not. To me, it's very necessary. That's my muscles will be stronger. My joints will be stronger. My tendons will be stronger. It's so much harder to overdo it than it is to underdo it. So even if it's tough, just go.
You'll know as you do it when you should stop or when you should get assistance. Like with my bicep earlier, I felt that strain. I know that strain is not a strain you're supposed to be feeling, so I stopped going full brunt with the muscle. I gave it a little bit of help. There's a line. There's definitely a line, but this is what the back's looking like. My back is super sore. I could feel it all right in that middle section right there, but overall developing. Might start getting abs. Not soon, because we got all this belly fat, but development is definitely starting to come through. Very minimal, but you know, it's what happens when you go on such a hard bulk. And now we're cutting. So I'll show you the wheel quad. One left quad, what we're looking like. Quad two, what this quad's looking like. Nothing crazy, obviously. The legs are really gonna be a lot smaller than my upper body, most likely, more than likely, just because of the way we train. You gotta pick your poison when you're natty. Or you could go on a slower cut, less aggressive cardio, and gain more mass with your legs, but that's just not me. I'll focus on gaining mass in my legs when the time comes. Almost forgot to show you guys some chest development. So, pecs are definitely growing for sure. Day 44 dinner. Why do I have a side part? Mom, where's the heroin? I might have to cut that out. That might be too much. But this is what we're eating for dinner. We got my two yolks. One of them broke when I was cracking the eggs, but yolk one, yolk two, probably around 4 to 5 ounces of chicken at the bottom and a half cup of rice. Keeping it simple, but that is it for day 44. If you're enjoying the series so far, definitely like the video, subscribe channel, and turn on post notifications so you don't miss the rest of the updates. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Deuces.